what I've come to know about Olathe North in the running game right here. It's smash mouth. It's in your face. It's drive, drive, drive. Make people hurt. Pick up some extra yards. He's going to carry that whole team.
Holy mama! Quinn Cunningham scores two rushing touchdowns, throws for a touchdown, and returns an interception for a score. Salina South will play for a state championship 1 week from tomorrow.
Two as a starter as Sellers rolling right and going to be hit and taken down. DJ Wild and Johnny Trumbull, a linebacker, collaborate, and that's going to wind out the clock. And Olathe North, a team that everybody wanted to put in the grave, said their dynasty was over. Gene Weir's down in Texas. They lose their first game. Well, everybody has some crow to eat as the Eagles are champions for the fourth straight year and the seventh time in 8 years. Congratulations to John McCall and his entire staff of Dave Nolan, Jason Herman, Jay Jones, Greg Beggs, Jesse Owen, Pete Flood, and defensive coordinator Chris McCartney. Eagles are champions of 2003 as they finish up at 10-3. And we're back to wrap things up from Lawrence and the 6A state title game after this timeout on the high school game of the week. Country Club there in the swan area. End around play. This is Dolan breaking a tackle down the sidelines, turning on the Jets. Look out. He is going to take it to the house. Touchdown. Jason Dolan.
Good combination. Waters and Oliver been good all day long.
First and 10. Holton with a seam off the left side, breaking free. Foot race to the end zone, won by number 20, Chase Holtum. It's a 45-yard touchdown run for the senior tailback, Chase Holtum, and it's now 21-12.
You like to see the ball before then, but you got it. You know you're going to get hit. You might as well catch the football.
Gino Waters to try a 24-yard field goal. Line drives it through. Seven from the 17. Out of the eye. They pitch it back. Cunningham has blockers in front. Has the first down and more. Turning on the Jets. And they're not going to get him from behind. Quinn Cunningham will take it the distance. Touchdown. 83. Now there is a flag down back in the play. Let's hear from the men in stripes and Randy Fineff, your white hat. It's coming back.
Wow. You're talking about a deflator right there. ...yards every single play.
Cross sweep, short side, Denning on a cutback. Denning breaking into the secondary, free. It's a foot race. Inside the 30, using the stiff arm. Still fighting inside the 5, first and goal. Wow. What a run, Michael Denning.
Down to 90 seconds, third down and goal. Quarterback sneak, Waters gets it in. Gino Waters, touchdown.
And he finds for the, he tries for the attempt.
Waters the extra point, he got it through! 22-21, Blue Valley, 1:25 to go in the 5A state championship.
I think I heard Steve Rampy say they've got to go deep now.
Right. Well, they have to because if they stay in bounds, well, there's one more play to go, 6 seconds. They have no timeout. It's fourth down, fourth and seven.
If they're still on the sidelines.
Well, this is a long field goal.
57 or 58-yard field goal. So they're going to have to go for the whole ball of wax here. Your state title game on the line, barring penalties. Fourth and seven. Sims. The pass is complete. Lax gets out of bounds with no time on the clock. Ball game over. Blue Valley wins it.
Wow.
Flax made the catch, dove to the sidelines, could not stop the clock in time. And it's a frustrating finish for Salina South. State title number 3 for Steve Rampy and the Blue Valley Tigers.
Kevin, this is a good football game. It came down to the last nitty-gritty, last 2 minutes of the offense, last 2 minutes of the game. Tigers have been in this situation before, coming back from behind. Methodically work the clock. Did a good job. Fun game.
was coming north ever since I was a little kid. My dad played here under Coach Weir, and I think Maurice's dad played here also. So it's just, you know, it's a family tradition, you know. You come here and you expect to win, and you work hard at it.
Cause it a dynasty, but it's, you know, this program has worked, you know, their butts off, and their coaches have been doing their job, you know.
So fundamentally speaking, Olathe North is the best team you have seen thus far.
Watching them tonight, when you look at the young men on the offensive line and also on the defensive line, pad level, the way they bring their feet, the way they drive, their execution is so far and above than anything I've seen. And we talk about those guys up front, Travis Greer, Brent Sensenick, Michael Rourke, not the biggest men in the world, but fundamental technique and strength. That's why they're on top.
I'll tip your cap to the Olathe North coaching staff. A lot of veteran coaches. safety slot. It's going to be third down, 13 yards to go. Miller with his first pass over the middle, deflected, intercepted. And coming away with it is Randy Shepard. He's the fastest guy on the field, has the 4.36 40 speed, and he goes out of bounds inside the 15 near the 13-yard line.
One of the things he talked about is the weight room that they have. Guys are working out 12 months out of the year, and you can see it on the field in terms of strength, quickness, and athletic ability. They're that much better than anybody else.
Boys, I'm Alabama bound. I've got my pistols in my pocket, boys, I'm Alabama bound. Well, I'm not looking for no trouble, but nobody dogs me round. Now, well, I'm going to fetch my woman, people. Try, should it, here I come. Oh, well, I'm going to fetch my woman, people. Try, should it, here I come. Cause she was raised up on that cornbread. I know that woman, give me some. Give me some, baby. Alabama people, don't you try to dog him round. Now in the kid is Alabama people, don't you try to dog him round. Cause if you people cause me trouble, Lord, I got to put you in the ground.
into the future. I want to fly like an eagle to the sea.
formation on 3rd and 10. Play action pass rolling left to Shamoff. Sits in the pocket under pressure. Now goes deep for Joey Hartman. He dives and makes a one-handed grab inside the 5. Holy mama! What an unbelievable catch by Joey Hartman at the 3-yard line. A 26-yard pass, and Joey Hartman just bailed out his quarterback.
My head to
half to go in the first quarter, 7-0 Central. Here's the option play. The give is a Craig Durfee. Nope, it's a fake, and here's the option play. Near side, and Cunningham is loose. To the 45, 50, down the near sideline. 40, 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Cougars. 7-6, South is right back on the board.
South to force line of Central upon here.
Casey Beggs, low snap, handles it, has plenty of time. Low line drive kick. It's going to take a bounce. Picked up by Cunningham at his own 35-yard line. Angles to the right side, tries to get to the wall, to the 40-yard line, gets a block to the 45, 50, down the far sideline. Here's Quinn. He's got one man to beat to the 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Salina South. The Cougars take the lead. Four plays. Cunningham goes in motion, far side. They run the option play. Cunningham gets some blocking to the 10 to the 5. Breaks a tackle. Touchdown. First play of OT. Touchdown, Quint Cunningham. Yards. Power ice set. Johnson, Pierce in front of Sharp. Cooper toss sweep to near side. Sharper's bundled up, and he's knocked for no gain. He got back to the line of scrimmage, maybe lost a half yard, nowhere to go. Sean Piatzik right there to make the stop. And now the Mustangs will burn a timeout here in overtime. Fourth down and goal from the 3-yard line. This is the football game now. Ice set, tight end right. O'Neal split far side left. Fourth down and goal from the 3.5-yard line. Keith Cooper fakes a toss sweep, now rolls left side, wants to look in the end zone, lobs it up in the back of the end zone, and slipping down is Radke. Salina South hangs on. Salina South will move on to the semifinals. They beat Salina Central 21-14 for the second consecutive season.
and I ain't got nothing to say. I come home in the morning, I go to bed feeling the same way. I ain't nothing but tired, man, I'm just tired and bored with myself. Hey there, baby, I could use just a little help. You can't start a fire, you can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire, even if we're just dancing in the dark.
Third down, 9 from the Great Bend 33-yard line. I formation, toss sweep far side for Quinn. He wants to throw the football. He's got a man. If he gets it to him, Dolan makes the catch inside the 10, and he will stroll into the end zone. Quinn Cunningham, a 33-yard strike to Ryan Dolan.
I'm just living in a dump like this. There's something happening somewhere. Baby, I just know.
Deep down the seam again, and it's going to be intercepted by Cunningham. There's the nail in the coffin right there. Cunningham down the near sideline. 35 gets the block to the 30, to the 25, cuts back to the 15-yard line. Now he's going to go to the far sideline. Cunningham to the 10, to the 5. He dives to the end zone. Touchdown, Salina South. Holy mama.
We'll be right back.
I remember a lot about Olathe North, especially walking out onto the field pregame and seeing how huge they were. To be quite honestly, it kind of set us all back a little bit. I remember looking at everybody and we were going, oh my gosh. I mean, their offensive line was massive. You know, I'm thinking they were averaging, you know, like over 265, 270 across the offensive line. And we were like, oh my gosh, like they looked like a, you know, a Division II, or, you know, they looked like some major, major athletes out there. So that was the first impression, you know, seeing a team that just looked like they were going to be physical, and they were.
It's real simple. You got two more quarters and that's it. Now most of you have been playing this game for 10 years. And you got two more quarters, and after that most of you will never play this game again as long as you live. Now you all have known me for a while, and for a long time now you've been hearing me talk about being perfect. Well, I want you to understand something. To me, being perfect is not about that scoreboard out there. It's not about winning. It's about you and your relationship to yourself and your family and your friends. Being perfect is about being able to look your friends in the eye and know that you didn't let them down because you told them the truth. And that truth is that you did everything that you could. There wasn't one more thing that you could have done. Can you live in that moment as best you can with clear eyes and love in your heart? With joy in your heart. If you can do that, gentlemen, then you're perfect. I want you to take a moment, and I want you to look each other in the eyes. I want you to put each other in your hearts forever, because forever is about to happen here in just a few minutes.
To say this, but I feel like the turning point a little bit was Dustin Moomau was their quarterback, and he was a phenomenal quarterback. The guy could run the option, he could throw. He was a big time threat, but they also had him on defense playing safety. I had to get up field and put a block on him, and I got my hands on him, and he was kind of backpedaling with me a little bit, and he just went down. It wasn't really anything that I forced upon him, but he just went down, and he ended up, you know, after the game, come to find out, he blew out his ACL. So not to say that that gave us a little bit of confidence, like, hey, we might have a second string quarterback came in, but it was kind of like, here's our chance. You know, something has finally gone our way, you know, honestly, after getting dominated a little bit from a team that was, you know, definitely larger than us. And so I think that was a little bit of a turning point. And the way that we stuck together.
we get late in the game, and man, I'm thinking they're not going to buy this, but I'm going to try it anyway. We get into our robust set, which is, you know, your T backfield. It's double tight, full backfield with a T set, and we run just a ISO play. 3 minutes left in the game, and the reason I'm doing this, I think it was a counter play, but the reason I'm doing this, the next play I'm going to run a counter pass where we try to get Quinn out of the backfield and up the sideline. Mm-hmm. So I run the counter, and I'm thinking, they're probably thinking, what are they doing? They're getting in power set. We're down 14-7. There's 3 minutes left in the game. So the next play we run this, Quinn gets loose on the sideline, and Steven Shamoff was our quarterback, and we didn't throw it a ton. And Steven launched that thing, and when he threw it, I thought, oh my gosh, he overthrew him. He threw it a mile, and Quinn is out there, and I'm thinking, there's no way. And Quinn was really fast, and he got to it, got underneath it, caught it, scored. Next thing you know, it's 14-all. We've got momentum.
And then we also had Quinn Cunningham and Steven Shamoff throw a phenomenal pass. I mean, I think Shamoff threw like 65 yards in the air, it feels like. It might not be that, but that's what it seemed like at the time. But yeah, I mean, the comeback there was just, it was surreal at the time, and it still kind of is, to be quite honest.
Wish I could swim like
Gore from the 8-yard line, first possession of overtime. Cunningham goes in motion, far sideline. They hand it off for Craig Durfee. He lost the football. Now he's going to throw it. He's got two men wide open, and Tyler Bradshaw makes the catch in the end zone. The exact same play worked last week against Great Bend on a reverse to Durfee. He fumbled the football. This time, Tyler Bradshaw makes his second touchdown catch of the season, and South scores on their first possession of overtime.
How we can be heroes just for one day. How we can be heroes just for one day. We'll be right back.
standing by the wall. And the guns shout above our heads. And we kiss as though nothing could fall. And the shame was on the other side. Beat them forever and ever, and we can be heroes just for one day.
Yeah, it was a phenomenal moment to know that we've stopped this offensive powerhouse, Olathe North. You know, Olathe North had been written about, you know, in the Olathe newspaper or whatever it is, about how they were supposed to be the best team that Kansas City had ever seen since Darren Sproles back then. And so it was all kind of hidden, the excitement. You know, we knocked off a team that the newspapers and the media said that we could not beat, you know. So in the end, you know, the moment was huge. I mean, it was fantastic. Yeah.
I feel that chill, smell that fresh cut grass. I'm back in my helmet, cleats and shoulder pads. Standing in the huddle, listening to the call. Fans going crazy for the boys of fall. They didn't let just anybody in that club. Took every ounce of heart and sweat and blood to get to wear those game day jerseys down the hall. The kings of the school, man, where the boys are fall. Well, let's turn and face the stars and stripes. It's fighting back them butterflies. It's calling in the air all around. Yes, sir, we want the ball. And it's knocking heads and talking trash. It's slinging mud and dirt and grass. It's I got your number, I got your back. When your back's against the wall, you mess with one man, you got us all. The boys are fall. In little towns like mine, that's all they got. Newspaper clippings fill the coffee shops. The old men will always think they know it all. Young girls will dream about the boys of fall. Well, it's turn and face the stars and stripes. It's fighting back them butterflies. It's calling in the air all around. Yes, sir, we want the ball. And it's knocking heads and talking trash. It's slinging mud and dirt and grass. It's I got your number, I got your back. When your back's against the wall, you mess with one man, you got a soul. Fighting back them butterflies. It's calling in the air all around. Yes, sir, we want the ball. It's knocking heads and talking trash. It's slinging mud and dirt and grass. It's I got your number, I got your back. When your back's against the wall, you mess with one man, you got a soul. The boys are fall. We're the boys of fall. We're the boys of fall.
Now this is the best. Last year that one was the best. We're all the best when you win them.
No, we just had good, solid football coaches that knew what they were doing. And then our kids bought in and they taught the concepts, and we had athletes. The linebacking core you mentioned, they were great. Barrett was terrific. And then another kid, Ross Ritter, started at guard for us. He started at guard and played linebacker, two very physical positions, and he never came out of the game. Was just a legit linebacker. Durfee, our secondary, without question, was the best secondary that I've ever had. Durfee, as a strong safety, was legit. T.J. Inkin was an outside backer who sometimes walked up and played on the end of the line of scrimmage. Was also a fullback. And then when you have Ryan Dolan and Quinn Cunningham as your corners, they're long, they're athletic, they can run. And then Dustin Heckroth was a terrific free safety. And we had a bunch of good free safeties. But you talk about a guy who could run and finish the deal. And in our scheme defensively, the free safety was always a pretty big piece in the tackling part of it. Mm-hmm. And people say, well, that's the bad thing if your free safety makes all the tackle. Well, it depends on how you do it, what you do. And he could run the alley and he could make the plays. And then we were good up front too. Dan Fox, Josh Hill was up there, Brandon Lester, I believe. You know, we just had good kids, and the biggest thing is they did their job and they played together, and it was just a lot of fun to watch that. And they were so well coached by our coaches, and those kids bought into what they were doing. They knew what they were doing. They executed every game.
To Gore. He's going to try and bounce it outside. He's not going to get there. Salina South will hold on. The Cougars have scored 21 unanswered points, and they have shocked Class 5A in the state of Kansas. The Cougars get their second state championship in school history as they upset the top-ranked team in Class 5A, the Olathe North Eagles. South 21, Olathe North 14. Holy mama, the Cougars are state champions.